Well, the awakening is going more and more rapidly, and it's a shock to the system for sure. On the edge of panic, and it's a matter of staying away from that panic, sitting quietly. The recognitions are so profound that you just sort of say, okay, try not to react to them too much. Stay with the process, as always. So when one sets discipline, that's what's important. I did a list of the top spiritual influences on my path today. Came up with about 32 of them, maybe actually 33. Came up with 33 top influences. Thinking of doing a video on it. Maybe I won't have the. Maybe it's not as important. It's not important. What I found was it's what's important is the discipline that anything instills within you to make the effort, especially sitting quietly and processing the shock. For example, the shock of, we hear about the void, crossing the void, the real shock is the realization there is no void to cross. And that in turn seems to shatter our whole conceptual structure, or at least it we realize it's not necessary. And that in turn seems like a void to us. So then it seems like there is a void. It's double paradox. The realization that there is no void is the realization that there is a void. Okay, now, so what do you do with that? That's where I'm at right now, the double paradox. And so I just need to, there's a bird making a little noise there. I just need to, the double paradox is there, okay. Not used to seeing that. So in other words, seeing further, you get into this double paradox, which is itself, it seems to be an infinite paradox regression there. So what is the perspective on that, is the question at this time. Can't rest on past laurels, so looking back where I've been, well, it's not really as relevant as where I'm at right now. And where I'm at right now is discipline. The ability is result of discipline. Result of simply a tremendous amount of time sitting and letting the shock of all of this gradually dissipate. So it's possible then to get to the shock of this double paradox. And the discipline is simply to say, okay, I'll just remain quiet and let the wow of this be as it is. Don't struggle for answers. It's enough to see it. It's enough to see the double paradox. Seeing in itself is really the answer. And don't struggle with that. Don't struggle with that either. Whatever in your life that causes you to stop and say, well, wait a minute, I just need to sit here quietly. This is really heavy. You have to really do it. You know, it's not, the path is not really a conceptual, intellectual situation. That plays a minor role in processing a little bit. But at some point, your conceptualization should bring you to this wow, like, whoa, I just need to stop here for a moment. That's what's important, is to consciously stop, to choose to stop, to be in charge of your stoppage and say, hey, time out here. I'm going to take a time out here. I'm going to take a time out from rushing forward. I'm going to take a time out from trying to, you know, be a world beater. I'm going to take a time out from this. This is very important here. I just have to take a time out and just sit here and just... Now, a double paradox, there's no way to adjust to it, actually. There's no way to adjust to it. It gets you coming and going, so. This is a feeling. There's nothing one can do to it. There's no adjustments that can be made, actually. Now, first, when you stop and take a time out, it seems overwhelming. And this is too much. But as you sit quietly, gradually, it will seem to soften up and not seem to be quite so much. And you keep on going. You just keep on being very patient with it. One moment. Okay, and at some point, you can't really know when. It lightens up somehow. It gradually lightens up. It gradually lightens up. Problem in this world is the demand that everything be sped up. For instance, and the Silicon Valley is the heart of that speed up of the world. The whole world's being sped up. It's the attitude that we need to speed things up that's the problem. We really need to slow things down. That's the truth. Because the more we try to speed things up, by the way the world is going, it's not possible. This is a delusion. You know, when people are going into a new cycle, the delusion is that they're going to be enlightened. They're going into an enlightened age, enlightenment. Problem is, they're frantically speeding up into that. And that itself precludes their awakening. You must realize the golden age is right now. It's always right now. This is the golden age. We're living in it. We're always living in it. The golden age is right now because maybe everything is everything. Maybe everything is everything. It's always the golden age. So the whole notion of going into a golden age, it just increases the delusion. There's nothing to go into. So somehow, the thing is it looks like you can't help anyone, but you can. It will just seem ridiculously implausible to them, and yet it will be helpful. They're simply they will simply start slowing down is all that will happen. And then they will say, see, this is the golden age. They will interpret that way. It's proof. That's the paradox again. There's the proof. The realization there's no such thing as a golden age is what brings about the golden age. Which in turn brings about the realization there is no golden age. It's always this double paradox. It's always this double paradox. Just when you thought that getting past paradox was easy, then you see the double paradox. Brings you back to zero. Slowing down into zero. Actually, slowing down into maybe zero. Slowing down into maybe zero. People have to say, oh, it's the golden age, because that's what they've been aiming for. So of course they say, oh, here it is. Here's the avatar of the golden age. Here it is. And you know, they're going to say that. What can you say? It both is and it isn't. It's a maybe, isn't it? It's a maybe. So maybe is the word. Maybe is the key word of enlightenment. Maybe is the key word of help. Because you cannot, it's a double paradox. You can't say it is, you can't say it isn't, and still be helpful. Because we need to rest in maybe. And they'll ping pong between maybe it is, maybe it isn't, maybe it is, maybe it isn't, maybe this is it, maybe it isn't. They'll build you up, they'll tear you down. Build you up, tear you down. So it's one thing to be, maybe everything is everything, abide in that. It's another thing to help others, because they will be ping-ponging. The mind will be trying to, not able to sit in the double paradox and abide in the maybe everything is everything, the double paradox. Not able to do that, they're going to be unstable. And this is why quiet sitting is so important, so important. We're not trying to say this is it or this isn't it. We're trying to rest in the maybe everything is everything. And this, the pressure, the speed, the push that we have is trying to push us into everything is everything. It's trying to push us into happiness. It's trying to push us into an answer. But it's really trying to push us into a quantifiable answer, which there isn't. So the best we can do is maybe everything is everything, zero times zero. And they will think, well, that's not enlightenment. That's not what I really want. What I really want is, no, it's not what they want. It's what, but it is what they really want. Because they want to resolve the continuity fear. What we really want to do is resolve the continuity fear, because that's the only problem we have. So I'm seeing when the double paradox reveals itself is don't jump, just remain quiet. Because the opportunity seems to be extreme for people to say, you know, this is it. But you got to realize there are also extreme opportunities to say this isn't it. and so you may jump into it. So it's important to not jump into it. When you see the double paradox, just keep sitting still. Don't do anything. See, they want you to be the avatar of the new age. They also want you to be the martyr of the new age. To show that they're great, they're more preferred than that. To restore the idea of preferences. Their Janus mind, two-faced mind, so to speak, unstable. So don't jump into the instability thinking, wow, I could be the golden avatar of the new age, so to speak. Because the other side of that is you're going to be the martyred scapegoat of the new age also. Because if they find, say, that you are it, you're preferred, then by destroying you, they feel they've taken your place. Now they're the ones that are more preferred, and you're less preferred. They've just proven that you're less preferred, you see. So the shock is that you think you see a way to help everyone, and yet that isn't the way to help everyone. And so the disappointment shock, oh my gosh, I have to, you know, I can't do it that way. Wow. Very heavy. That's what I'm experiencing now. I'm struggling. Very heavy realization. Wow. This is coming. This is just like a tsunami hitting. So when the tsunami hits, remember, don't struggle. Try to figure it out. Like, how did I get into this? What triggered it? It's already popped. The tsunami's hit. Here, you know. The ocean is receding. You know, the tsunami's, you know, coming or something. Or it's already popped. You know, the balloon has popped. Wow. This is the path. You start talking, you start contemplation, you know there's something is ready to pop, something's right. You look at it, and as you're looking at it, it pops it. Boom, it's popped. It's just like, wow. And then you have to, the aftermath is, this is the second part of inquiry, the aftermath. You inquire, you look until it pops, and then aftermath of wow. Shock to the system. Overall shock to the total system. Total system of what? Expectation, which is how we function, does it, is it not? Do we not function with expectation in all ways? Okay, again, don't look back to say, to revisit the popping of it. Try to figure out what to do by revisiting it. No, it's too late for that. It's already popped. It's already popped, you see. So just stay with that realization. It's already been seen. Don't go back and try to see it again. That's when you get lost. It's kind of like the ocean is receding and you run at higher ground and you think, now wait a minute, is there a tsunami coming? Let me go check again. You go running out of the ocean again. Well, then it's too late because you're going to get hit by it. So you want to get up to the higher ground of consciousness. consciously abiding, consciously sitting quietly, maintaining your equilibrium at some level here. Because the equilibrium has just been thrown out of whack in a deep systemic way. So you need to reestablish, you know, the fact you do have equilibrium, certainly at the level of the body and functioning, the level of expecting this is would happen. There's equilibrium there. So at some level, what you have to do is say no to the "I didn't expect this," and say, "No, I did expect this. This was expected. And abide in that. It was expected. And so a new locus, a new center of expectations is born. It's like a birth. You say, "Yes, I did expect this." So, and then you coalesce around that new center of expectation. "I did expect this, absolutely." So you go into spiritual practice with a positive expectation that you are going to have a breakthrough. There's no question about it. You're sure of it. So when it happens, you say, "That's fine, I expected this. It's not a shock to what my spiritual expectations." This is the way. This is the way of success. Is you expect success, and that enables you to deal with the success when it comes. You cannot go in super skeptical. And so you can't be forced. You cannot be forced. You cannot force others. That's not right. It's going to cause a lot of severe problems. You have to go in saying, I know I'm going to have a breakthrough. I just know it because I'm making the effort. I'm ready. I'm going to do it." And then kabloom, wow, the bloom pops. The chocolate melts away. It's in the sun, and it's just turning into goo, just melts. It's gone. You know, the structure's gone. It melts. You realize you can't get it back. I mean, when you see a chocolate bar melting, like on the dashboard of a car, and you open it up, say, "Oh, I hope it didn't melt. It's melted." You can't put it back into that nice, crisp chocolate bar, can you? It's gone. So this old structure is gone. But I expected it. That's fine. I expected it. Again, don't look back. I was looking back. Wow. Don't look back. It's already happened. The results are going to be there automatically without, pushing anything. Once the balloon pops, the chocolate bar melts, that structure is gone. That structure is gone. It's not coming back. Wow. And it's always like, "Oh my gosh, I know I was trying to melt the chocolate bar, but I'm kind of like, it's shocking that it's melted, because I was kind of used to the sharp definition of it, and now the definition is melted." So with success comes a bit of remorse, buyer's remorse, definitely. You go in and get that new car, and it's the car you always wanted, and you walk off the lot, and you realize, drive off the lot, actually, and you say, "Wow, it's too late now. It's too late now." Shopping's over. Yeah, so there's some remorse there, right? Buyer's remorse. So you're not really remorseful. You say, "This is what I really want," but wow. And the thing is, there's nothing you can do about it conceptually. You just can't spin the wheels. don't spin the wheels. It's too late for that. So it does take time. The spiritual path does take time, patience. There's no way around it. So it's simply the ones who have been patient that succeed. That's it. There isn't any other secret to it. You have to exercise patience. And the anxious, eager ones are in a hurry and say, no, I don't have time for that. It cannot succeed that way. It cannot. And there's nothing you can do to make them succeed. So you have to simply continue to be patient and realize that. You cannot be the golden avatar of the new age. Patience is the golden avatar of all ages. It's already that. Holy Spirit is always the golden avatar of the new age, always. Before we were patient, the Holy Spirit was patient with us. Maybe I'm the golden avatar of the old age, but I'm not the golden avatar of the new age. That's for sure, right? Having already exercised patience, you can say, I can relate to that, to having exercised the patience. But I'm not the golden avatar of impatience, which is what the new age is all about. They want to find something that which justifies their impatience. Can't be that. Too late for that. Too late for that. That's also part of the shock. That's also part of the shock. There isn't any role for me in the new age. Which then say, wow, where do I go? Where do I go? And then that has to, become apparent, right? What do you do? Well, you can help others, but ultimately they want to know, where do I go? Where do I go? It's different now because there's a new age coming. So the question, where do I go, is important. It's vitally important. And that, I think that has to be part of the whole thing at this time. That's why Jesus said he's coming back at this time. It has to be part of that, the spiritual experience at this time. I believe it needs to be part of the equation at this point in time. That's how I'm looking at it, that's how I'm seeing it. But where do I go then? I cannot be the avatar of the new age. Absolutely not. I cannot be the avatar of impatience. I'm the avatar of patience, because having already done it. Again, so interesting. Very interesting. There's another wow right there. And maybe that's why I'm feeling so down and like collapsed, bad health, collapsed, everything. Because I don't know. Where do I go, so to speak? Where can we go? Where can those go at this point? Who, that's a hugely important issue, actually. that has not yet been addressed. I've tried to address it and have not got the answer yet. And all the platitudes don't work, spiritual platitudes. Well, there's nowhere to go, you know. The new age is here, you know. It's here. And they're all frantically looking for the new avatar, this golden age and new age, to justify their impatience, for sure. And I'm not it. And paradoxically, I am it, but I'm not it. I am a golden avatar, but not of the new age, is he? I mean, in other words, the patience has been already put in. And so the problem is, you know, everybody else who's also been patient, they're also saying, well, what do we do? So how do you help them if you don't have the answer? This is something that has been with me forever. You know, this whole life, how do you help people? If you don't have the answer of, well, how am I going to fit into this new age? How can you really help them? Because that is fundamental, actually. Fundamental. I told the Holy Spirit, you know, Holy Spirit, hey, you know, I feels like I got a problem here. It feels like we got a problem. Scripture says Jesus is coming back. And he's made a place for us to go to, actually. Those at the end of the age who have reached the point of, who have exercised the true patience, so they're ready for the maybe everything is everything. Maybe everything is everything. He supposedly has made a place for us to go and dwell with him. You know, makes sense to me. It makes sense to me, actually. But, you know, where's the proof? I've seen some proof. I was taken somewhere that was the death-free realm, and I seem to indicate this may be where you're headed for. Because there isn't any opportunity here, really, for the golden avatar. It's a false opportunity. You have to see that. Wow. Because at first blush, it seems like, wow, I really have the opportunity to be some great golden avatar, the new age, and really help. It's not there. It's a double paradox. It's a double paradox. So that's what I'm seeing now. Wow. Double paradox. You're also going to be the martyr, you know, to galvanize the new age. To say, look, we thought you were it, and we were able to crush you. You're not it. We're it. That's impatience. We'll do that. Right? Amazing stuff. Wow. Well, maybe that's the next straw, you know, the next step. It probably is, after seeing the double paradox now. Wow, bird just arrived here. He's right here. Hey, bird. Wow, that's amazing. Maybe that's why my debt's not being cleared up. Maybe that's why my problems are not being taken care of. Maybe we're at the step. Interesting, right? Soccer match today in Brazil. I usually don't watch soccer. I watch this one. It's the most incredible thing I've ever seen. Sporting event. I've never seen anything like it. Everybody just saying it's the most incredible soccer match in history. It's true. It was. It absolutely was. Stunning. Stunning, stunning, stunning. Germany represented what? The impatience. Brazil, the patience. What happened? Patience. See, Brazil plays to slow build up, second half team. Gradually they take over in the second half. That's their style. Germany style blitzkrieg. Blitzkrieg. They completely blitzed the Brazilians. And Brazilians simply were stunned and turned into spectators. And then the route was on, the greatest route I've ever seen. Most unexpected route ever seen, I think, in any sporting match I've ever seen. Germany scored like four goals in about 5 minutes. You know, so it was 1-0, and then suddenly it was 5-0 before 30 minutes even passed. Four goals in like 5 minutes against the Brazilians? I mean, that's impossible. And so the German style was this ferocious, mechanical style, and it's just like, Brazilians are just like, huh, you know, what? Watching, we're just watching. They're just watching. God watching. Boom, 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 boom. And it just snowballed, the whole thing snowballed. And then Brazilians just gave up. That's the new age. That's the new age. Germans are the new age. You just saw the new age. And what happens to the old age? The Brazilians are the old age, the style. It's a rout. It's a rout. You know, people are expecting 1-0, you know, overtime shootout, penalty kick shootout, 2-1 maybe, you know. 7-0, it was 7-0, just like, you know, and then Brazil, at the very end, they scored a goal because people were just distracted like that, you know, it's finished. But that was shocking. That was a big wow. This is a new age. German style was new age. Brazilian style was heart, emotion, love. Love of the game, love of the people. And they're very emotional. And they couldn't deal with the German blitzkrieg. The new age is a blitzkrieg. And what are the German goalkeeper, I mean the Brazilian goalkeeper say, well, it's time to go home to our families, is what he said. It's time to go home with our families and be with the people that we love. And that's it. Well said, well said. Amazing. I said the whole thing would turn in Brazil. I've been saying that for quite some time. Little did I know it was a soccer match which would point it out. Because the whole world was watching this. This was the stunning event. I didn't know what it would be. This was the stunning event that took place. There's more people watching that match than almost anything in history. The whole world was watching that match. And you saw what they saw what happened. And just everybody stunned around the world. I knew there was going to be some very stunning event in the World Cup. I didn't know what it was. I didn't want to say what it was because I wasn't sure. I thought maybe some terrorist thing or something, but I didn't know. I didn't know. I really didn't know. This is what it was. This is what it was. Utter destruction, domination. That seemed impossible. Brazil's greatest tradition in history of soccer, football, and what, a 5-time champion in their home country with the whole crowd roaring and the whole country in support. You think they're going to play the game of their lives. This is going to be an unbelievable match. And of course, we knew Germany was very good. But the U.S. played Germany, well, it was 1-0, I think. So we didn't think they were that good. But holy cow, they were ferocious. I've never seen anything like it. It's the best soccer I've ever seen, the way the Germans played. It was the most decisive soccer, technically great soccer I've ever seen. This is just mind-blowing. This was not beautiful soccer. This was technical soccer. So this is the world got the shot. This is the event. I didn't even realize it until now. And it's amazing. I just watch it. Usually I don't watch it at all. I haven't watched the World Cup at all. And in past years I have. But I just happened to be there because someone else was there in the house. They wanted to watch it. So I turned it on for them, and I said, I'll let you know what happens, and they're working. And so I said, hey, they scored a goal. Oh, okay. And so they said, they scored another goal. They scored another goal. They scored another goal. They scored another goal. And they go, what? Are you kidding me? Nobody could believe it. I was telling people, it's 5-0 in 30 minutes. They say, you're crazy. No way. It's impossible. It was right there, man. It was like, whoa. Welcome to the new age. See the devastation that it brings. Brazilians are patient. They were going to play a patient style, you see. And look what happened to that. Interesting, very interesting. I need to go now. But thank you for watching. It's all on now, isn't it? It is all on. Remember what I said. Where did the patient go? Where is their place? Where is their place? Because it's not here anymore. Thank you very much. Take care.